Isaac and his mother lived alone in a small house on a hill. Isaac kept to himself, drawing pictures and playing with his toys as his mom watched Christian broadcasts on the television. Life was simple, and they were both happy. That was until the day Isaac's mom heard a voice from above. Your son has become corrupted by sin. He needs to be saved.
I will do my best to save him, my lord,
Isaac's mother replied, rushing into Isaac's room, removing all that was evil from his life. Again, the voice called to her. Isaac's soul is still corrupt. He needs to be cut off from all that is evil in this world and confess his sins.
I will follow your instructions, Lord. I have faith in thee,
Isaac's mother replied, as she locked Isaac in his room, away from the evils of the world. One last time, Isaac's mom heard the voice of God calling to her. You've done as I've asked, but I still question your devotion to me to prove your faith. I will ask one more thing of you.
Yes, Lord, anything.
Isaac's mother begged. To prove your love and devotion, I require a sacrifice. Your son, Isaac, will be this sacrifice. Go into his room and end his life as an offering to me to prove you love me above all else.
Yes, Lord, she replied,
grabbing a butcher's knife from the kitchen. Isaac, watching through a crack in his door, trembled in fear. Scrambling around his room to find a hiding place, he noticed a trap door to the basement hidden under his rug. Without hesitation, he flung open the hatch, just as his mother burst through his door and threw himself down into the unknown depths below.
Yeah, all right. I mean, we've already seen it before, I'm sure, most of us. But anyway, welcome to Isaac Rebirth. I've already put a fair amount of time into this. Actually, let me just take a look at Steam real quick. 41 hours. Holy shit. All right, so, got a few characters. Got one I think I don't have. What do you mean win streak -4? I just got off the back of an Eve win. This game lies, I promise you. Anyway, not actually sure who I want to be here. I've got Isaac, Maggie, Cain, Judas, the Blue Baby, Eve, Samson, Azazel, Lazarus, Eden, 9 Eden tokens, goodness me. And, or I could spin the wheel. You know, we will let fate determine who I play as today. How exciting. Oh my gosh. No mercy on the first run. Jeez. Alright. Well, at least the item room's right here, and it's, I think that's Mum's eyeshadow? Charm tears. So charming. Alright. Really, what a... This game is relentless. What a harsh first choice. I gotta play as the Blue Baby. I mean, I don't have to. That is, That's what happens when you leave it to the wheel to determine your fate. This could take a while. Lots of poop to clean. Oh my gosh, that's a nice way to start. The butt penny. Actually, that's not great. I'm pretty sure that just makes it so that when you walk over a coin, you fart. Alright, well, may as well make use of this poop. Hey, nice, a coin. Yep, that confirms it. Toot on picking up cash. And not only did I get the Blue Baby, I also got the cellar, the difficult alternative of the first floor of the basement. Hey, Charm, go fight on my behalf. Oh, no, that ran out because you're far too slow. Yeah, some of these enemies are rough. Right, these spiders will explode when I kill them, and that wall spider is, he's alright by himself. When you get down to the catacombs and the depths, those things turn real evil, and they come in multitudes. Hey, now that's a much better trinket. Trinkets normally don't drop very often for me, so I'm kind of happy I'm getting... Oh, I'm going to take damage in this room. I took way too long to get off the starting blocks. So, the blue baby. Why does the blue baby suck if you're not very familiar with Isaac? The blue baby does not start with any red hearts. He starts with soul hearts, which means to keep the run going, you need to encounter either HP up items or more soul hearts, which is not too common. I'm actually going to dig around for more drops before I go to the boss. Might find something useful. What was my item? It was the charm tears. Let's blow this up before it maximizes and starts chucking out more spiders. Spiders are so awkward. They have very odd movement patterns. You can't control them. They seem really erratic and all over the place, but you can kind of put a leash on them and dictate how they move around, which it's not easy to do if there are multiple spiders in the room. Once you start narrowing it down, it gets a lot easier. Or peeling them out one by one. I would tell you what the trick is, but it's a lot easier to show it. I'm not going to be able to. I think that was a tinted rock there, but I have no... Yeah, that's a tinted rock, but I have no bombs for it, unfortunately. A damn shame. This first boss, I can put my money on Haunt. It's Pin, okay. Pin ain't so bad. Pin is not as easy as he used to be. Well, I mean, he would kill himself with his own bombs. He does not seem to do that anymore. So, yeah. Normally, if he shot those bombs too close to himself, he would just chunk himself at 50% HP. He's easy enough to beat though without that. Just made the process a lot faster. Hey, Squeezy, that is wonderful because tears up and two soul hearts. Beautiful. Alright. Still no bombs. This poop is not going to be helpful. Actually, I'm fairly certain the poop got more helpful in Rebirth. I think you can blow it up to make a bridge. I've not had the chance to test this yet, it's just something I read. I would like to put that to the test. I'm fairly certain that was not an attribute in the old game. If it was, I cannot believe I did not find that out from just browsing the web. I need to... Ugh. I'm gonna need to... Playing and talking is so difficult, my gosh. I'm gonna have to shut up when it comes to a difficult room, or I will take damage like that. Because that was definitely avoidable with the right pace and movement. Avalid's pill is, the dream pill, of course, is Balls of Steel. Balls of Steel gives you two soul hearts. Is it gonna be that? It is, ugh. What is this pill? Are you a wizard? It makes your tears come out of the, like, diagonals for a certain period of time. Really not helpful at all. In fact, I think it wears off after about 30 seconds, or after you shoot enough tears. I'm not sure what caused it to stop, but I really don't want to go into a new room with this. So to kill the time, I'll just traverse back and go this way instead. Come on. Don't make me wait too much. How's it going? Oh, there we go. This is a really nice room. Jeez. There we go, it's one off finally. Wow, really, what a nice room. Normally this shit is hidden behind a bunch of rocks and stuff. Alright, what is the dream item to find? Whore of Babylon is wonderful for Blue Baby, since it's always active. It's a damage and speed buff when you are at one heart or less, one red heart that is. But Blue Baby will never be at that one red heart because he cannot get them. The game considers him permanently in a state of where he can be buffed by Whore of Babylon, plus other items that require that sort of... What other items have criteria like that? Not necessarily an item, but the champion room, the champion challenge room, that is going to be permanently open. These red hearts are worthless for me, unfortunately. Darkbum. Darkbum is the dream. Darkbum is really, really strong. Probably borderline OP, but that's what this game is all about, right? Yeah, Darkbum would be nice. Anything that just pays out in soul hearts. The relic, I've not seen the relic in this game yet. I've not seen... what else? Hey, soul heart, nice, wow, that was lucky. I think the mitre, the Pope hat, causes soul hearts to drop more frequently. Apparently Mum's Pearl does? Never knew what that trinket did in the old game, but... Supposedly it causes more soul hearts to drop. That's a Malibu. Get away from me, buddy. I may as well poop every room. Might find a goodie in it. Did find a soul heart much just now. That was generous. What else is there? There's the Book of Revelations. That thing is incredible. Invaluable for someone like Blue Baby. Come on. Oh my god, that's a violent jump. Alright. Ugh, are you a wizard again? I do not wish to be one. Larry Jr. Hey, I've charmed him. Is he eating himself? Oh my goodness, I think he's breaking himself for me. Wow. That was... that was incredible. I wonder... Does he eat the poop if I put it down in front of him, or does he just rebound off it and go in another direction? He drops a soul heart. He gives me speedball, so I get a nice cute face with weird eyes. And deal with the devil. Which I... Oh my goodness! Doubt I will be investing in. Oh, you know. That could be really good. I mean, I'll kill myself picking it. I won't kill myself. I think I have enough hearts. Can't tell because I have Curse of the Unknown, so my health doesn't show up. But, Spirit of the Night gives me flying and spectral tears. Awesome for this game, but I don't know, kind of cheesy. You know what? I'm going to pass. Half because of fear of dying, half because of it's kind of cheeseball. I don't know. If I see flying in the future, I probably won't pass it up again, though. Under better circumstances, of course. Well, I do have more health than I thought. Goodness. Coming out of the basement with that much health. This Blue Baby is quite nice. I'm not gonna start that. I would rather put this key into the item room than gamble it for some garbage. I could chain keys together, that would be incredible, but likelihood of that is, well, unlikely. Hey, my charmed buddy just blew up both the bats for me. What a helpful chap. Curse you, red hearts. You are no help to me. Oh, there we go. Now these spiders are getting violent. So these wall spiders, there are three variants. The kinds who shoot three innate bursts in a single file, in a straight line. The easiest kind, there are these who... they move with their own accord, but they fire a triple shot in a sprayed... like a widespread variant. And then there's the really nasty ones who shoot brimstone lasers. And always seem to show up in pairs of four on different walls, like adjacent walls. Ugh. Foul things. Hey, it's a poop room. These are a new enemy, and they're kind of rough if they dash at you too much. There's another one in here somewhere, I can hear him. There he is. This guy can dash across the whole screen, as we'll find out here. I'm just gonna let him do his thing, see how far he goes. Come on. Dash me. I dare you. Here he comes. Whee! That is such a... He can go across the whole room from off the camera, I'm fairly certain. I would rather not find that out the hard way, because if he hits me unexpectedly, I will be upset. That's what he excels at doing. Catching you off guard. Alright, I have one key. Best place to put it is in here. That is... Robo Baby? Yeah. He shoots a tech laser. Not very fast. I wonder if my tears up scales with him... I think it does. I would like to think it does. And I hope I find some tears up, because... Robo Baby can be nice. Oh god, I nearly walked straight into that. This is a rough room. I should get rid of one of these fat bodies so I have more room to work with. Hey, that guy got charmed, and I think he just exploded all the flies. This charm effect is really nice. I don't think I've had it before. I have had it before, but I've never really seen it in action. Oh crap, I just stood in that creep without looking. That was a mistake. Hey, a coin. Nice. These poops have been pretty generous. Normally you'd need a trinket to make them... Oh my. I can outrange these things. I just charmed the... I'm charming the ads that come out. I thought that would... I didn't think that could work. They don't... I guess they're sort of considered enemies themselves, but invulnerable. But still attackable or affected by, tear effects. And there's a brimstone dude. Not pleasant. Yeah, these guys are normally kind of rough. Especially when there's so many of them in a room, but this is a long room, and the ones with the slug variant can be outranged, so they're not too bad. This is a nasty room. It doesn't seem too bad. Oh, okay. Well, I thought they were going to spit tears at me, but I guess that's... they've been broken down to the point where they don't shoot tears. So that wasn't so bad. If they were spurting blood out everywhere, that would have been pretty nasty. I have been to the item room, not to the shop. I don't have a key. I would like a key before I go fight the boss. So I'll check down here. Hopefully this is the last room for me. Besides curse rooms that I do not really care to venture in, or sacrifice rooms I do not care to cut myself on. Ugh. I'm gonna carry on this pill for actually I'm just gonna drop this pill. Oh, I dropped my matchstick, whoops. Give me that. Alright, no bombs. Oh, I do have bombs. What am I talking about? I can check for a secret room. Could be here. I think it could be. Ah, I picked up that damn pill again. I'll just leave it. Whatever. Just try not to proc it. Okay, it's not going to be there or there. It could be. Could be there. Yeah, it could definitely be here. This is one spot for it. Wonderful. Hey, money. But no keys. Maybe a key in the fires? Nice place to keep a key. No, okay. Never mind, we will continue on. I will not go in that sacrifice room, not as this guy. Not unless I had a very reliable source of soul hearts being generated, which I do not currently. So I'll go fight the boss, and it's the catacombs, so... Oops. Yeah, it's the catacombs. This is probably going to be a nasty boss, I'm going to guess. Who can I actually get in the catacombs? I'm going to guess... The husk. I don't even know how to say that. Polycephalus? I don't even know. Not a nice boss. I'm still trying to work out how to fight it. It crawls on the ground, and it can show. It could be ages before it shows up. It only shows up when it's right next to you, and even then, I was right on top of where the mound was. So, I don't know. It's like if you get too close, he's gonna pop up and smack you, but. Sometimes it pops up generously, other times it doesn't. And you end up too close to it and it does this instant spray of bullets and just nails you like that. Luckily, I think they all go in the same direction though, so... Like a monstrous lung kind of shot. More money. Shame I cannot find my way into a shop, because that would be really helpful. Let me see, actually. No, that was not connected to the shop. Alright. Kind of disappointing. We'll have to bypass that, despite all of our coins. Hopefully we'll find some keys in the catacombs too. The catacombs being the hard variant. Ugh. Well, actually, of all the variants I've found being hard, I've started in the cellar, now I've got two catacombs. What was floor two? Was that the basement or the cellar? Guess it doesn't matter. Oh, man. I should get rid of this spider before I do anything else. Alright. Luckily, those spiders, as nasty as they can be sometimes, are extremely fragile. These things, on the other hand, are incredibly durable. And... I think I made him jump to the fire. The Joker. I'm actually going to use that right now. Oh my gosh, that is the dream. The pact. Take spirit heart, but it gives you back too. You wouldn't be able to tell because I have Curse of the Unknown again, so I have no health being shown. And spiders. If that had dropped spirit hearts, this would have been the dream room. And this is Ghost Baby. It's a companion that fires spectral tears. Kinda bad. No thank you. That was the IO wizard pill. I will dodge that. Oh, this is a rough room. Oh my god, this is a rough room. Alright, try and get these spiders one at a time. And hopefully these big flies don't get in the way while I'm killing them. Which, it looks like they will. Yeah, I can just kill the flies, actually. The spiders doing their own thing. One of them's getting kinda close. That dark green one is going to explode on death. I think that champions who are a very dark green, they just drop a bomb on death rattle. I mean drop a bomb. What I meant to say was explode, not drop a bomb, but that one actually did drop a bomb, so that was convenient. Hey, champion challenge room. These things are always open for the blue baby. Very nice. I know. Never mind. Cannot open that. Do not have a key. Even if I did have one key, I probably would not invest it into that. So, we go, oh my god, it's Ultra Pride. That's a rare find. So, this guy is modeled after Edmund McMillan, the main developer of Isaac. On death, he drops the left hand, usually. I don't know if he can drop anything else. But it's a trinket that causes a lot of causes all brown chests and maybe gold chests to turn into red chests. I don't think I want this. Actually, no. I want to keep the matchstick because it causes more bombs to spawn, but the left-hand curse chests, they have a high tendency to drop soul hearts, which I need desperately to keep this run going, so I will rock the left hand and hope that this dark path does indeed reap good rewards for me. So, I will soldier. Oh my gosh. Hey, I've charmed him. Let's see if I can charm them all. That's probably the tactic. Just hit them until they charm and hopefully fire at other enemies. I guess if they're charmed, if they're not firing at other enemies, they're just not firing at me. They are still jumping towards me, which will hurt me. I actually have decent tiers now thanks to the pact I picked up, so that was the first major step up. Now I can start killing enemies a little better. Oh my god. A small room with a guy who shoots bombs. Hopefully I can keep him charmed and yeah, there we go. Hey, blow up the mushroom saw me. Thanks. Can you blow up this one too? Nope, I'm not gonna take the risk. Not in this close environment. Lucky to get out of there with no damage. I will turn right. Hey, Larry, with Tech Baby, or Robo Baby, that is an easy fight. I really need keys. So much money. Oh, gosh. Well, I mean, I'm not going to do it yet, but this is a good last resort. This is a really nasty room. These enemies are so weird. They're fast, and they split up once you kill one of the pack. Well, generally they do anyway. Maybe it's if you kill a certain part, like the middle. Yeah, I think if you kill one that was in the center of the pack, it will split the whole body up and they will go in their own directions. And they are nasty. Especially with those diglets, those tanky diglets. This is not a terrible room. If you keep on circling around them, they won't hit you. They will eventually decide to charge and they will go in that one direction where you were when they began the charge. So moving in a constant circle, you will not get hit. These charmed tears are really nice. Alright. More greed heads. Come on. Charm. There we go. I don't think he actually shot at the enemy. Actually, I don't think he's ever going to hit that red host. Because his tears go in a V pattern, which means if he points down there, he's never gonna hit. They're gonna spray off to the sides in a V shape. So a still moving enemy is never gonna be hit by a greed. So charming him was not very useful. But I mean, it stops him from shooting at me, so that's kind of useful. Hey, you guys are nice and easy because you're locked in one place. Means I can just attack you from above, and not from below. Nice and easy. Ugh! Screw these enemies. See, that guy dug right under me then. Luckily I was moving at the time. But yeah, these guys can pop out from right underneath you. It sucks. And apparently I found a key in the middle of all that I didn't realize. So I will go open up the item room. Actually, no. I have a lot of money. I should go to the shop. Since I have a chance to find another key. Which I didn't, but did find a very cheap bomb, which I will take. And a dime. Sweet. And the compass, I will definitely take that. And I have a lot of cash, I'll just donate some of them here. Donating, once you donate enough coins, stuff appears in the basement and upgrades the shop as well. The black candle. Now, I know the blue candle is in this game. I've not seen it yet, but if the black candle is in this game, that thing's gonna be bitchin', right? That thing's gonna be great. I will probably use this. Yeah, I'll absolutely use this guy now. So, one there. The secret room, the super secret room might be here, but not the actual secret room. Alright, so that has carved the path for me to start paying out. Alright, buddy, give me some keys, give me some keys. Open your heart, be generous. What is a good item? Justice is a good one here. Oh, that's awesome too, the Hierophant. That gives me two spirit hearts. That is wonderful. And, yeah, just fucking me now, aren't you? I have 9 coins left. I think it's worth it, dude. If I get one key out of these 9 coins, I'll consider it worth it just to get in that item room. And that was good, too. It's HP up, which doesn't actually give me a red heart with this character. It just gives me more blue hearts. one blue heart in this case. So, Hierophant, two blue hearts, wonderful. Can I get a key off of these chumps? That is the dream. Hey, a charm, nice. I don't think they can damage each other. Green enemies like that do not take damage from their own poison bombs, so... What can you do? What can you do? Hey, these are easy. Just outrange them. They are rooted to the spot. I don't think they even shoot from that kind of distance. Even so, my Robo Baby would reach all the way across. Sadly, no secret room. So, sorry, no key. I meant, where is the secret room? Can it be there? Can it be there? To the left here? That is plausible. Let's continue checking. Yep, still plausible. Looking good. Yep, I can break it into it. I'm not sure where it is on that wall, so... It may still be wrong, but it's likely here. Nice. Okay. Alright, so what am I looking for? Balls of Steel is good, but anything that can get me a key from a pill... I don't actually know. Right, hopefully this is a good pill, because having a triple of a good pill... Hey, speed up. Well, it's okay. It's gonna be a little disorienting. It's not too bad, that's manageable. I did not find any keys for that item room, so that is really sad, and I'm still not willing to, damage myself on the spike room to, hopefully get a chest with a key. So I'll just soldier on. Oh my god, I stepped on a spike, like an idiot. Speed up pill? Nah, I can't blame speed up, that was my fault entirely. It's the husk, alright. The Robo Baby should help with this a lot. I say a lot, it'll just be kinda helpful. I'm pretty sure Robo Baby's instantly blowing up all of those flies he's spawning. Oh, he drops spiders too, okay. Of course he does, it's the husk. So, stem cells is HP up, and a devil room. Oh, I Joker carded here earlier, so, was it a Joker card or a tele pills or teleporting chest? I don't know, but, we saw Ghost Baby, do not want, will not have. We'll soldier on, we will bypass the item room, that is a damn shame. At least the shop that I spent my key on did have a useful item, it had the, compass, which is gonna point me in the direction of the mini-boss room. And a challenge room. I know all my tears are hitting that skull, but at least my Robo Baby's technology laser is going through. Oh, crap. Ah, no. Nice, there we go. He can kill himself in those blue spike traps. I totally forgot he could do that. Sorry about the dark effect, by the way. I've got the Curse of Darkness, which means I have a sort of flashlight effect. A torch, if I'm gonna stay true to my, British origins. I've been hanging out with my American friends far too much. So yeah, the room is really dark except around me, which makes it a real bastard to check for tinted rocks, but, this curse chest hopefully has, not spiders, but, soul hearts. It does, that is wonderful, and I got a bunch of Marowaks, that is not good. These bone-chucking assholes. There we go. They don't seem too bad when you look at them, but when you get in line of sight of them, ouch, they shoot really fast, and they can curve their bones so that they're not going in straight lines up, down, left, and right. A straight line. They don't just necessarily go directly up, down, left, or right. That's the trigger that little where they'll throw, but they can sort of angle off to the left and right, which makes it kind of tricky, and getting to this boss room might be tricky. Actually, it'll be fine. Just need to drag that over here. There we go. It's Envy. Hey. This Robo Baby will make Envy fairly trivial, I'd like to think. The spikes will do no damage to him, but they'll do damage to me. Quite unfairly. So with Envy, more reliable to break the smaller pieces up first so that you have less overall to deal with, but that's not as fun, is it? Let's just break him all up. And try and dodge it all. Nice game of asteroids. Well, I guess it wasn't as bad as I thought. Super Envy was, I'd probably be less careless with Super Envy, since he breaks up into a lot more pieces overall. And the game sucks. Gave me a troll bomb and a troll heart. Yuck. Alright, this is... No, I can drag these out, it's fine. I was cautious around those things, but then you look at them and they think, eh, they're not as bad as they first appear. Cannot see any tinted rocks out of those. This dark mess. Yuck. Can it be a secret room there? Potentially, yes. I think. Yeah, there's definitely an option for a secret room there. Not that there'll necessarily be one, but. Hey, I can actually cheese these guys, right? Yeah. Let my robo baby do all the work. Can I still hit them when they're invisible? Ah, you know what? This is gonna take forever. Come on out, my friends. Oh, my stomach's rumbling. Dude, I'm hungry. I should have eaten before I started this. Because this could take a long, long while. My run's generally... I've had my tab up for a while. That map has been quite obtrusive. I normally like having it up, but I can understand that some of you may prefer to have it minimized. Yeah, the runs... I normally like to be really thorough with every floor and maximize as... get as much out of it as I can. So my runs generally take about an hour every time I play this. Assuming I stay alive, that is, and get as far as I normally can. This room kinda sucks. I'm a little stuck for space because of the rock formation in the middle. That was unfortunate. If I can take another one of these guys out. Yep. And he's charmed. Is he gonna shoot his friend? Wow, that is... he took out the champ. That is awesome. Okay. That's a key. I really needed a key. Nice. This room sucks. Hey, he's charmed. Kill your friend. Nice. Those guys have a fair amount of health. Oh god, three of these things. Luckily, starting quite far away. Robo baby doing work. So tanky! Died, damn it! Oof, dodge more. And a charmed fly. And a pill. Okay then. It's explosive diarrhea. Run. Alright. I would like to get that. See, explosive diarrhea. It would have been nice if I'd have known what it was and I'd cast it in this room, but... what can you do? Maybe I'll get something that'll let me get it easily later on. This is potentially a really crappy room. Actually, the poos in the middle make this quite easy, because they probably won't dash through and hit me, they're just kind of rebounding off. As long as I don't cut through them and blow them up. Ah, there we go. Yeah, that was easy enough. And now for the big guy. Does he explode into one or two medium-sized poops? Two? How unfair. Well, the charmed guy dashed the wrong way. That was nice. And a bladed room. I'm still not comfortable going into those, despite having 7 hearts. Those things can disappear easily. If I had a constant reliable source of hearts, I would be much more willing to go inside, but not quite yet. Alright, what are we looking for? We're looking for bombs, clearly. I actually don't have that much money anymore, since I donated a little. Maybe a slight mistake. I also gave a bunch to the beggar. Still not sure how I felt about that. Oh no, I'm taking damage in here. I'm absolutely taking damage in here. I'm gonna take multiple amounts of damage in here. Yeah. They're all grouped up. Maybe I can make something happen here. That's one down. Oh, these things turn on a sixpence so easily. Will you settle down so I can murder you? These rooms, possibly quite manageable if there weren't these awkward chasms in the floor, which not only limit my maneuverability, but they block the masks off and cause them to sort of freak out and sort of rebound all over the place. With things like masks, you can normally kind of get them to go in a particular direction for a long while and lure them over in the corner. With these things, you lure them out and they get, oh, freak out, oh, I'm stuck on the chasm, all over the place, and then they just start bashing you over and over. Ugh. Speaking of which, there's more. Alright, they're all over there for now. They got stuck on the rock again, will you? Ugh. Alright. If I trap myself in the corner, I will, surely kill myself. Ugh! Such a delicate process, I was hoping I'd do that without taking damage. And these things, those hearts are all tucked behind a rock as well. So I can't easily get a shot on them. Oh, man. One pit at a time. Hey, once charmed. Nice. That does nothing except just make him stand still. Which is potentially helpful, except not really. I was hoping he'd actually go in and bash the hearts out. What is that thing? Broken remote. It's broken. I think that causes me to randomly teleport someone when I pick up items. Oh, yeah. Didn't even mean to do that. I actually just meant to poop. I think that's a... No, it's not a tinted rock. Never mind. I need to get off this floor. It's so dark. I'm gonna go and get my left hand back. There we go. And explode this. Sweet. I can make some real use out of that teleport with the poop, since it recharges so often, but I don't fancy randomly teleporting everywhere, you know? Hey, that guy's charmed. That's really helpful, because he kind of caged me in. These guys will dash you when they're close enough. You can kill them safely from range, but the room is pretty limited right now for space, so eventually one will get close to me. It's hard to kind of... There we go. He has to move into my line of sight because I can't really get underneath him very well because of the blood trail. Come on. I'm missing all my shots. There we go. Just have to wait for the trail to expire. I have keys. Finally, an item room. It's the spoon. Homing shots. Could be kind of helpful. Certain enemies. This would have been helpful on that mask room where the hearts were tucked in an awkward place. I could have just kind of angle them and they would have naturally curved towards the enemies, hopefully. Well, this is a kind of weird room. I just gotta try and outrange the chub ones and generally stay out of line of sight of those laser ones. Almost screwed myself over. Ah, no! Yep, I made a mistake. He was a double-sided enemy, so he shoots out of his back as well as his front. Yuck. Oh, that's a chub one. What am I scared of? I can get near that guy. That's a laser one. There's one more down here somewhere. Oh, he's running away from me, the coward. There we go. No drops from that nasty room. Are there any other interesting rooms? The shop. Potentially interesting. It sucks. I should probably invest in this. Whatever. I just won't buy anything from the shops in future. Hey, this room kind of sucks. I hate these masks. They seem really easy to dodge, but they're so fast and often in large groups that they rebound off each other really awkwardly and hit you when you least expect it. And it's the bloat. Hey, I started above him. That's really helpful. But it kind of sucks because he instantly jumped towards me. So the trick of the bloat is to not stand directly beneath him or directly to the sides because he has a really nasty instant laser. I just got hit by the eye like an idiot. And again, wow, they rebounded off each other. Okay. I'd really need him to jump down. The trick with the bloat is to get above him. Alright, there we go. So he's below me, and he's going to be stuck there now until he jumps again. Which he already did. That sucks. Instant laser. Oh man, please jump again. Could let my homing tears try and do some work, but look at that blood creep. Ah, stop jumping, dammit. He knows he's in an awkward spot, and he jumps back up. Normally he kind of stays down there and gets stuck. Alright, here we go. This is the moment. Just stay there. God damn you. Alright. I need him to stay down where the blood does not stay up. Man. He's disobeying right now and I'm losing focus and I'm getting hit by the eye. Hope I don't die here. Alright, well, this just sucked. This really sucked. The bloat was being a bit of a pain. Right now he's stuck, but the eyes are getting near me. This is the ideal place. You want to be above him, you want him to be stuck there, kind of just pissing out this blood or whatever the, however the hell he gets it out of his disgusting body. And you want to just dodge the eyes. It's so easy to forget the eyes like I did. Oh man, I got murdered there. I know the tactic of the bloat, but The eyes make it so awkward, and these rocks as well. They made it kind of awkward as well, because I couldn't angle a tear onto him without him kind of getting in the way. I think, do the eyes rebound off those? No, they don't. I don't know, that was just really tricky. Anyway, enough excuses, let's carry on. I doubt I will make it much further. This is a really, really rough run. Depth 2, Curse of the Lost, my map disappeared. Alright. If I beat Mum's Foot, I will consider this a victory, to be honest. I had a pretty lousy run. Kind of short on bombs and keys. Didn't really have any good items, did I? I managed to get the Pact, which is a good item for the Blue Baby. But I didn't get a true Soul Heart generator. Nothing reliable. What pill was this? I think I had this before. I did not. Balls of Steel, please. Oh, health up. That's pretty good. Gives me one Spirit Heart. Oh, these ghosts. They're not so bad, actually. Just need to kind of wait for them to spawn, then move away. The way these ghosts work is, they disappear, they reappear near you, and, the moment they kind of take a snapshot of the moment they reappear and where you were standing, and that's where they fire. So, for example, he'll spawn near me, he'll shoot there, and shoot where I was before I moved. So you just stand still, move, and shoot at them when they appear, and it's not too difficult. They are not as difficult as they appear. I mean, this kind of awkward room makes it not difficult, but just tricky to hit them. Inconvenient, there you go. For example, they're appearing behind rocks right now. There we go. I should be able to kill them, there we go. So, yeah, that's the trick with the ghosts. Not too bad, not too bad. This room kind of blows. Maybe the trick, what's the trick here? Trick's to get rid of the brains first or the flies? Probably the brains. I just do your best to dodge the flies in between. I will not take the battery in case I find a good spacebar right on this floor. The battery, by the way, new addition. It is a consumable, no, not a consumable, it's just something you walk over now when your active item is not charged and will fully charge it. It's really, really, really good for things like the Book of Revelations. And I'm probably going to take some damage this room if I don't kill one of these things. Oh, I'll be fine. I just need that thing to jump down towards me. There we go. Oh, and again. Nice. And you just need him to come to me before that spike trap reaches me. And there was a dead end. So, shit. Let's go back. I would really like to go over there, but I'm just not finding the bombs for it. The Hollow. I was about to say how easy this guy is, and then he almost hit me when he rebounded from the middle. Please just give me some bombs so I can make shit happen. Oh my god, I nearly walked into one of those things. So the skulls, yeah, the skulls are impenetrable. They do not take damage. They just hang around in the room until you clear out the real enemies. These guys, for example. There we go. Hey, a key. That is kind of helpful. Kind of had one already. Have I been in the item yet? In this floor? I don't think I have, but who knows? Hard to say when you've got Curse of the Frickin' Lost. I really don't like these fat guys. They're kind of easy to hit when they're on the ground. They spend more time in the damn sky, though. They jump, they land, and then they jump again almost instantly. God, I wish I could get that. Well, I did have the option to buy flying earlier. So that would have been my way out. I wonder if it would have been worth it. You could say I'd be dead right now if I'd spent those hearts. But, I mean, if I had flying, perhaps I wouldn't have taken so much damage. Wow, I really got hit more than I would like to there. Two cursed chests. I like my chances of getting soul hearts here. It's a pill. It's pheromones. That's kind of cool. Pheromones charms all enemies in the room, I think, including bosses, such as Loki. So hopefully, the next enemy I get is not a single boss, but rather a cluster of bosses, or some kind of... What could I get? Maybe the Hollow? I think I can charm the Hollow. I don't think I'll get the Hollow in here, actually. I think I'll get... I don't know who I'll get. Can't even guess. Monstro 2. Alright. Monster 2 didn't seem to be as easy as it used to be. Had an old trick. Maybe it still works. Hey, he's charmed, nice. So the trick used to be to stay near him, causing him to take very small jumps, and he wouldn't do the long high jump like that. The high jump is really bad, because, yeah, he's awkward to hit, he does a spurt of bullets, and he spawns adds when he lands. So you do not want him to jump. But he's doing it. Ugh. The other trick I think would work is to stay horizontal of him so he fires the laser every time he catches a glimpse of you, but move out in between, of course. But, I mean, well, he just did his laser anyway, because he was charmed, okay. But, yeah, he seems to be just jumping more than he... Yeah, he just seems to jump, like, regardless now. There's no sort of way to physically lock him down, as far as I can tell. I wonder if I keep him perma-charmed, will he not jump? Can I kill him for a jump? No. I got him before he spawned more adds, at least. And a troll bomb. This was not worth coming in here whatsoever. Ugh. Well, like I say, if I kill Mum's Foot, I'll consider it a victory. At this point, I cannot see myself going any further unless I find a game-changing item. I'm not even sure what single item can change the game for me right now. Pheromones will be nice in one of these rooms, such as this one. What am I doing? No, it's not. That's terrible. I might actually die. Do these things do a full heart of damage? I don't even know. Oh, I almost got hit then. They have really large hitboxes, by the way, which not only causes them to hit you easier, but it also causes them to rebound off each other a lot easier. That is a really nice find. In fact, perhaps it's not, because I might just get greed in the shop instead now. We'll see. I was just thinking, I haven't been in a secret room for a while, but I haven't had the resources to let me. No, lack of bombs is killing me. Really, when was my last bomb? How many floors ago? Hey, a coin. Still not sure if I found the item room yet. I'm fairly certain I've not found a shop yet. Ow. That was really dumb damage. I cannot afford to get hit again or I will die. So tense. Oh god. Oh god. Oh, I was close. So these are the spiders. The wall spiders. Two brimstone ones and two, and one spray one who's in the middle. God, I so should have died then. I was so lucky to not get hit by anything. Oh. Please die. Thank you. Now I'm safe. I think I'm safe, yeah. Had to get off that awkward starting block. I find I always take damage in rooms with these guys. They're really easy, but when you first walk in a room and they're all just against the wall and there's a bunch of them doing different things and you're trying to figure out what it is while not getting hit, that is awkward as shit, and I think that's IO Wizard. Yeah, it is. Ugh. I should drop it here. I'm not going to come back in this room. I expect. Get my left hand back. The poop. Any spirit hearts for me? Of course not. Hey! That is useless, and I cannot blow it up for a chance of heart because, hey, I've got no bombs. A common theme this run. This might be where I die. These guys aren't too bad. As long as they don't teleport on top of me, that's the nightmare. It's nice when they teleport miles away like that. That's the dream. Alright. Where's the shop? Oh god, oh my... That charm nearly screwed me. Caused him to just turn in my direction. Well, turn in my direction necessarily, but turn in a direction, which happened to be my direction. And I can't get too close to this guy because he will explode on death. And this charm is causing him to act all funny. There we go. I almost walked into the spikes. How am I not dead yet? Seems like an easy room. As long as I stay all the way over here. Too boring. Fight me, buddy. I dare ya. My magic tears are not doing a great homing job on this guy. They're going after the little nuggets, if you will. Alright, now we gotta be careful. So scary. Ah, that dash, oh my god. So unstable. Hey, a key. That's not what I was looking for, but okay. Oh my god. It's Darkbum. Whoa, okay. Maybe we have a shot. Are there any rooms that dropped red hearts? Because Darkbum exchanges... He picks up red hearts on the ground and exchanges them for blue hearts, which... Oh, man. If I find a red heart... I think I found one earlier, didn't I? In the challenge room? I don't even know where it is, dude. Curse of the Lost is screwing me right now. And if I go backwards, am I going to run into something nasty? Oh, I'm going to check it. Real quick. Got to find that challenge room. Hopefully I don't find a room with enemies by surprise that just murderize me. It's a battery. Can you reach that? I wonder. I don't think he can. Not what I was looking for. Where is this challenge? There it is. Alright. Oh, there was no red heart. God, that must have been the last floor or something. Well then. I gotta find my way back now. There was no reward at the end of this long path. Could have sworn I found a red heart somewhere earlier. And now it's evading me. My life could depend on this. I need the fuel for Darkbum. Where was I going? To the right. It was all the way to the right, of course. That's where I found him. This is where I was meant to go. Sorry, one second. Headset's being all weird. I dropped my left hand. No, I thought I just saw it on the ground. It looked like it was on the ground over there then, but it's in my trinket spot. Ugh. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, my God. Scary. Scary. All right. My homing tears packing up a little. It's greed. Of course it's greed. I should have known. He's charmed. Does that mean he stops shooting? No, it doesn't. He's still a piece of crap. But it does mean that if he spawns ads, he will shoot them, right? Hey, I killed him. So I had to kind of gamble there. Alright, there we go. No hearts. No hearts. Just cash. Cash that I could have spent in a shop if it was here. You bastard, greed. Please, I just want some bombs. It's Mum's heart. No, it's Mum's foot. I'm gonna die. I have nothing else I can do on this floor. I have to go in with one shot. I don't even do that much damage. Oh, no, I don't want to die to this chump. If I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die to a big stump. I'm gonna die to this guy's bullets, actually. Ah, nailed. Jeez, that was a rough run. Wow. Well, anyway. That was... Kind of took it upon myself by hitting random. I just wish I could have got more bombs. How many opportunities did I miss with chests that were hidden behind rocks or secret rooms that passed up and shit like that? Oh, well. Well, anyway. That was attempt number one. I would love to do more of these because I am pouring hours into this game at the moment. I will definitely record some more. Maybe I'll not hit random next time. Maybe I will. I don't know. I might just roll with Isaac or someone like, just someone kind of decent, reliable for a, hopefully an early victory rather than just delaying it by deaths. Oh man. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching and goodbye for now.